So this was Paragon Studios, mouthpiece for Nazi America, doling out rubbish propaganda to the masses. Spotted the glass-domed main offices draped in Nazi banners beyond the sound stages. That's where my target would be.
Dokumente von Überkommandant Hans Stieglitz abholen, Herrn Lorenz altem Freund. So ein Superattentäter hat ihn dabei erwischt.
Superattentäter hat ihn erwischt, verdammt. Alter, er war ein guter Mann.
Ja, wohl in Frieden, Kumpel.
Guards, this is Charles Lorenz speaking. As you know, I have a very important shoot coming up. Now, with the horrible murder of my friend Uber-Commandant Hans Stieglitz, I want everyone to keep their ears open and eyes peeled, all right? Don't want any degenerate terrorist sneaking around on the premises. Guards, it's Charles Lorenz again. I have told you countless times, no one is allowed to disturb me when I'm in the zone. Acting requires perfect concentration, and you are ruining the preparations of my upcoming immaculate performance with your constant idiotic interruptions of flimsy requests and complaints. Thank you.
The Paragon Studios office building looked exactly like the place a wanker like Lorenz would fester.
Everyone, the upcoming shoot for the new movie Blitzmensch Returns, Vengeance for the Aryan Race, has a guard role available due to sudden illness. The part involves no talking, and there will be free knockwurst. Now, since I'm sure there will be many volunteers, please form an orderly line outside my office later today at 7 p.m.
Ah!
You have a drinking problem, bartender in Sao Paulo once said. Bloody Nazis are marching on your streets and you're telling me I have a problem? The world had gone mental, and I just needed a drink. Maybe drinking wasn't the solution, but it sure soothed the pain. Look, what else was there? Anyway, I was a big... girl, and I decided when I could drink. Bloody hell, Jessica. Stop obsessing about your drinking. Thank you. I'd planned on spending the end of my days in Brazil. I was at the point where it seemed my years of strife were finally over. Jack was fading away into the distant past, obscured by the spirits medicating my soul. I should have realized that's not how life works. And now it came down to this. General Dunkel, the man who killed my Jack, the coward, had long ago decided to hide away on the moon. General Dunkel would be my last hit. Then I could go back to my old life and never return. Jack always said he was over the moon whenever something good happened. Well, my love, how I wish you were here.